which I'm sure everybody's heard, but you know, the ulama say that the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ is like a jar of musk. And each time the jar is open, we experience the fragrance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And you know, the hadith comes in Sahih Bukhari, Babu Janais. Hazrat Anas bin Malik read that there's many versions of this hadith, and it's narrated by much of the Muhaddithun, the great Muhaddithun. And this is in respect to the questioning, the mandatory assessment which takes place in the Qabr. And we're familiar and we know that the first question that will be asked by the angels, Munkar and Nakir, is Man Rabbuka, who is your Lord? And inshallah, we believe that the people of Iman, they will respond and they will say, Rabbi Allah, my Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to answer these questions in accordance with the way of the people of Deen and Iman and the Mu'mineen. And then the second question will be, Ma dinuka, what is your religion? And again, the Mu'mineen, or the people who had Iman, they will be able to answer and they will say, Deen Islam, this was my religion. And then the angels will ask, Ma kunta taqulu fi hadhar rajul or fi haqqi hadhar rajul. What did you used to say about this man? Hadhar rajul. What did you used to say about this man? I.e. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, I just want to bring your attention to the questions here. You know, alhamdulillah, there's many lawyers here, and this is also my field. When a lawyer cross-examines an opponent or a witness, he thinks 10 times before he proposes his question. He's so-called, he sort of puts his opponent into a corner to get the answer that he wishes to extract. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first is asking, who is your Lord? Okay? And you know, maybe even the Qadianis will be able to say, you know, my Lord is Allah. Who knows? And then the second question, and we know for sure that the first question will filter the kafir. Okay? And then the second question, what is your religion? There's a further sort of process here. There's a further stage of filtration which is going on here. What is your religion? Okay? And whoever answers Deen-e Islam, isn't it clear at this stage that your Nabi is Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? If you followed the deen of Islam, isn't it clear now and apparent that you believe in the final Prophet of Allah, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Then I ask you, what is the reason in the third question and why did it come in this order? We plan, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also plans. And He is ni'mal wakeel. And He asks, what did you used to say about this man? Hazrat Munazir Azam, Mawlana Muhammad Umar Chawi Sadiqi, rahimahullahu ta'ala, he used to say that this question, what it actually means for the people who are of bad aqidah and foul aqidah, and they believe negative things about Rasul Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, what it actually means is, ab batao, kya bakte rehte the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke baare mein. Tell me now, on the earth, what did you used to say about this man? He wasn't Hazir Nazir, he doesn't have ilme ghaib, he is an ordinary man, astaghfirullah, na'uzu billah. What did you used to say about this man? Again, we are seeing here, there's a filtration process. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is wanting to ascertain the aqidah of the person of the grave. Because it's already been established. You are from the religion of Islam, you believe in Allah. But no, Allah is now asking, what did you used to say about this man? And today, if we look everywhere, people are saying different things. They accept the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam as their Prophet. But they say, no, he had this limitation. No, there was this. No, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam couldn't do this. And there's all these problems. And we can't forget the Sahih hadith of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, where the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, indeed my ummah, sataftariku ummati ala thalathin wa sab'ina firqa. My ummah will divide into 73 sects. Not brothers
We're all one ummah, we're all Muslim, and that's it. Wahidatun fil Jannah, only one will go to Jannah. Wa thintani wa sab'una fil nar, 72, they will enter the hellfire. These are the words of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Harisun alaykum bil mu'mineen raufur rahim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is raufur rahim. But he is implanting these words. He is impressing these words. And it's something for us to think about. And I tell you this, and I leave you with this. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, who is the same sect? Who is the firqa-i najiya? The Sabatul Azam. They will be the al-jama'ah. They will be the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. This is another concept for another time, inshallah. But I leave you with this. Hazrat Ali Karamallahu Wajhul Kareem, he said, people in their life, they are dead. And when they pass away, when they die, this is when they wake up. Don't be that person. Don't wake up when it's too late. Wake up now. Look around you and ascertain the true aqidah of the Sahaba and Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah give us the ability and the facility to sit with the pious ulama and to take this treasure which is being stolen from us by people who dress in robes and deceive you and pretend to be people of haq. Wa ma'alina illa al-balagh.